In Brussels tomorrow, a judge will give his verdicts on the 26 British football fans accused of offences at the Heysel Stadium in 1985. 39 people died as fans rioted at the European Cup final between Liverpool and Juventus. A number of Belgian officials are also on trial. Today, a Belgian policeman who was on duty at the time of the tragedy claimed that senior police officers have staged a cover-up to hide their mistakes.
It's been one of the longest and most complicated trials in Belgian legal history, with a number of Belgian officials on trial, as well as the Liverpool fans, and hundreds of civil claims for damages from the families of those who died. The public prosecutor has recommended prison sentences of 3 to 4 years for 15 of the fans, against whom he says there's strong evidence. They all maintain they're innocent of manslaughter.
He didn't want to fight, you know, didn't go to hurt anyone, and I never really hurt anyone. I'd say I hit someone, but I never went to hurt him, I never hit him. It was just like defence, do you know what I mean? And it was just, then I realised there was something, you know, terribly wrong, but I didn't know what it was, but, you know, I knew there was something wrong.
Giancarlo Gonelli, a lifelong Juventus supporter, was amongst those who died at the stadium. His daughter Carla was also crushed when the wall collapsed, but was pulled to safety by a Liverpool supporter. Carla was in a coma for 3 days and remembers nothing of what happened. Her mother blames the Belgian authorities for her husband's death.
I know there were young people arrested, but however drunken and disorderly they were, it was the lack of police, the lack of organisation and the lack of assistance at the stadium.
During the trial here, the public prosecutor said the Belgian authorities had failed to segregate the supporters and the police operation was dogged by inefficiency, inexperience and bad communications. The officer in charge at the stadium, Captain Johan Mahieu, had never been to a football match before. He and his superior, Major Paul Concier, faced charges of negligence. But a former gendarme captain, who was in charge of one of the squadrons on duty at Heysel, says the real errors were made by more senior officers, who then tried to cover up their mistakes by concealing documents.
There was a mistake in the basic organization. The stadium was divided in two parts, one covered by the city police, the other by gendarmes, which I believe was a mistake right from the beginning. We didn't have enough gendarmes, and when the events happened, we could see there was a panic, even among the officers. And later, during the debriefing, things were covered up, and I believe this isn't honest.
The judge delivers his verdicts tomorrow, but the complex legal proceedings may not end there. All those involved can appeal to a higher court. Carol Walker, BBC News.